Oh no. Right, the camera, the phone has told me to Facebook has said move the phone. I'm not gonna move it. If I'm upside down for the whole of the video, then you just have to bear with me. Okay, so hopefully this is all okay. Right. So, I really hope you can see me. Okay, hi everyone. So my name is Simone and I work here at Caterwell Physiotherapy and Wellness. Today's live video, we're going to be continuing our theme that we are running here at the studio this week, which is take a breath. So I'm going to use a squishy ball, and you have got the use of a band at the end, but we might not use them. I'll give you alternatives to whether you use with or without, okay? So we're going to start by standing with our feet hip width apart, arms down by our side. And I want you to think about growing nice and tall. I want you to drop the chin, and I want you to, if you're comfortable with this, close your eyes. So I want you to just feel that you're in your space, making sure that everything around you is quite clear where you are, and that you're not going to fall on anything or cause yourself any accidents at home, because we really don't want that. So your space is nice and clear, and you're standing feet hip width apart, and you're going to close your eyes. And as you're closing your eyes, I want you to just think about growing nice and tall, pulling your shoulders down, having space between your ribs and your hips, and everything that's happened in the day so far. You're trying to clear your mind and let it go and focus on the here and the now. So hopefully that's okay. And if you're there in the zone, you're feeling nice, you're going to deep breath in through the nose and breathe out through the mouth. So let's do that again. Deep breath in through the nose, expand into your tummy and breathe out through the mouth. And while you've got your eyes closed and you're growing nice and tall, I want you just to sway into your toes and back into your heels. So you're taking your time, you're doing a nice little sway. Now, if your eyes are open, you might find that you can go a little bit higher, and I really don't want you to do that. I want you to just go forwards and back, and nice and steady, sway forwards and back. Try going side to side. So again, just really feeling where your weight is. We want it to be able, the whole body to move side to side, forwards and backwards. Taking your time, trying doing a circle, so you go all the way around one way and then go a couple of times all the way around the other way. So trying to keep your body nice and still, not moving your head or your body, we're not leaning, keeping everything nice and still, moving from down into the feet. Okay, so opening your eyes now. So let's just make sure we've got everything moving. We're going to do a quick foot pedal just to get the feet nice and stretched. As you bring the heel down, you're swapping sides. You're going to switch on a rise. And as you come back down, try not to sink into the hip as you go. We can do opposite arm to leg. Okay, good. Coming back, we're going to do a spine twist. So we deep breath in, and as you breathe out, you're going to go corner to corner, and then back into the centre. Deep breath in, breathing out. Back to centre, breathe in. Changing sides. Over, and the head is moving with the body, it's not overturning. What we're really trying to do is nourish the spine, get that mobility, but at the same time keep everything where it should be, so that's nice and strong. Rather than going side to side, I want you to feel that you're going corner to corner, so you're not overturning, the lower body isn't moving, you're not giving into the hips. Growing nice and tall, corner to corner, Okay. So we're just going to do a little lunge forwards. Coming back up again. Lift and come back to the spot. So we're trying not to take the weight forward. We don't want the body to rock. We're just going to go straight down and back up. And you're lifting up out of the way. So if I turn to the side, lift and together. And lift and together. So the weight is in the body. The knees are nice and light. Keep going. If you've got one of these squeegee balls at home, you can lift and lower. You can even take your arms a little bit higher. Keeping the shoulders down, nice soft elbows. So we're really getting the body nice and moving. So you breathe out as you go down, in as you rest. Okay, nice little warm-up exercises. If you've got hold of that ball, you can do a nice side breath over and then swap and lean, pulling it again. Pulling up out of the waist as you go. Nice breath, nice and slow. So again, you're not trying to crunch, you're trying to lift and elongate as you go all the way over. Good. Okay. Let's do one last. So we're just going to come up. We're going to take the arm out to the side and back in and change. So again, getting that nice space in the upper body. Weight forwards into the toes. If you lock your legs like I do, you want to try and have soften those knees slightly. I know that feels like you are not doing it properly. I promise you are. So growing nice and tall. And again, if you've got that ball, you can just take it out to the side and change. Nice and fluid, nice and smooth. Four and three and two and one and relax. What's really good with doing Take a Breath Week. Things, exercises going at a slower pace can also mean that you are really working on that activation of the breathing and the pelvic floor connection and the pelvic floor along with abdominal connection. So for all exercises, we want to try to activate our pelvic floor and try to keep it lifted for the duration of the doing part of the exercise. If you find that's really hard to do, then make sure that you're doing pelvic floor exercises when you that are separate to Pilates. So maybe try and fit them in around. So what we really want to do is, as we're activating our abdominals, our pelvic floor is switching on and connecting at the same time. Okay, so we're going to come down to the floor. We're going to have a little shell stretch, taking our arms forwards here. And we're going to then cross over to the side, feeling that nice stretch back to centre and change. And that's just getting a really nice stretch in the lower back. Okay, a really nice exercise to start with, especially to link the breathing, is the side mermaid. So we're coming down onto the floor with one foot in front. So you've got one leg in front and one leg behind. If you find that this is a hard position for you to sit in, especially hip and knee, maybe not so much the knee, but the hip replacements, or you just find this uncomfortable, your posture doesn't feel right, like you feel like you're too far back, you can have your legs in front or cross, or you can even come up onto the knee. So what we're going to do is take our arm up and we're going to side bend as we go all the way over and then bringing it back down. And side bend. And over. So again with the ball, we can side bend, stretch. Trying to keep everything nice and still. That's quite quite easy when you're up here to let the body go, so I really want you to keep it nice and still. And if you are in this position here, as you lift, and you can increase that by bringing the elbow down to the floor, and then coming all the way up and up here. You can maybe even twist over to the side. So you're getting a really nice spine twist without any pressure. So let's go once more, this side, and swap legs. So again, making sure you feel nice and supported. One side might feel a bit tighter than the other. You might feel that your posture isn't as good on this side. And if that's the case, always try to start on the side that feels tougher, because then you can swap it for next time. So we've got a nice side bend as we come back up. Deep breath in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Let's do one more. Okay, good. So don't forget, Facebook Lives, we're on here for a shorter time. So this video can always give you the ideas, and you can practice in your own time, and you can add a few more reps on each time. Okay, we're going to do a nice breath with our leg to the side, coming into making like a triangle. We're going to bend from the elbow as we lift the arm all the way up to the ceiling, and then slowly bring it back down. So we're trying to keep our lower body still, and really twist our upper body, look to our hand, and lower it back down. And again, lift. Now, if this is available for you to do and you're feeling okay, what we're going to do then is take the leg back and push up into a triangle plank. So we're going to hold it for two, one, and lower. And swap sides. So again, rather than open the arm here, what can happen is that we're too far open. So if we bend from the elbow, keeping our hips still as we twist to look at our arm, and then coming back down. And this gives us a really nice upper body stretch, really working the shoulder blades and really pushing up as well. So we're getting that nice core activation. And lower. We're going to take the leg back. We're going to push up into this triangle plank. Stay there, stay there, stay there. And bend and relax. Shell stretch for me. So again, pushing up into that plank, if that doesn't feel right for you, or in the wrists, you think, I can't do that, then we're going to leave it. You can always just do the stretch here, and then come back down and leave the plank. So moving on to a side plank, again, let's give our wrists a rest. Say that a bit clearer. You're going to come onto your elbow. You're going to lift up from here, so you're not sinking down, you're pulling up nice and tall. You're going to take the arm over the head, you're going to do a really nice side bend, and then come back down. And again, you can use the ball really nice to take it all the way over and lower, and all the way over and lower. And again, you don't need to have the ball. You can have the underneath leg bent, and that will give you a little bit more support. Pull the shoulder down, lifting from here. Lift and lower. And again, if you want to make it harder, and only try this if you've done this before, bring that leg in front. You can keep the legs bent, if that helps you, or straighten them. Breathe in, breathe out, and lower. Good, okay, we're going to lie on our backs. We're going to a few variations here. So we're going to float our arm, we're going to press our spine into the floor. We're going to float our arm back as we change arms. And we can. So easier version is just lift the knee up to tabletop, bring it back down. Lift and lower. So each time you change, you breathe in and then breathe out. Okay, so you've got the spine is pressed into the mat. You've got a nice gentle breath that's helping you with the movement. If you think I've got that and I want to progress, coming up both legs up to tabletop, taking the leg off and in. As you switch, you've got time in each one. And if you find it hard to keep your legs here, you could just stay here and extend the leg, keeping the ball nice and still here. And that does take the leg a little bit higher, but it just helps to keep that knee stability. And as you can see, the legs are going to move around. An easy one, if you've got the ball here and you just want to work the upper body, and just take the arms back only to about here and then stop. So the ball can be a really good visual, or you can just do alternate arms. Now if you've stretched your hamstring, you can use the band. You can give your leg just a nice stretch. And one of the favourite exercises is a shoulder bridge, which you can do anytime, anywhere. Stretching the hamstring before you do the shoulder bridge is really nice just to make sure that the legs don't cramp. So using the breath, deep breath in as you breathe out. Lift and lower. Really taking your time. Shoulder bridges are great exercises to do because they're using all the muscles and they really help to give you that really nice stretch. So take a breath, weak, you can really take your time engaging your core, and that breath pattern works really well, especially if you find connecting the correct breathing with the exercise. This is a really good exercise. It's functional and it uses all the muscles. So I know it's a popular one and you can put it in any class because it's that good, but it's a really nice one to do today. Okay, we're coming down onto our tummy. We're going to swan prep. So the key here is to tuck your elbows in as much as you can, switch off your lower body, and you're going to lift. Come down. As you come up, you're going to press into your hands and your elbows and keep the shoulders down and then lower. And again, breathe out as you lift. So the tighter the elbows are into the body, the harder you will find this because you'll be more restricted. And this mean that you don't come up as high. You don't want to press all the way up here because all that's going to do is really shorten your spine and put it under pressure, which we don't want to do. So let's just do a few more. So deep breath in, breathing out as you lift, pull the shoulders down, coming up just to a point where you feel that your spine is nice and stretched. Feel like you're pulling your abdominals off the floor as you lift and lower, and once more.
into the shell stretch. To release that lower back and then come sitting. So again, like I've already said, you might want to do a few more reps of each exercise that we've done, and that's absolutely fine. I just wanted to give you one more that you can take away with. So really getting that mobility into your spine. You can do this exercise with your legs together or with your legs apart, maybe just apart or a little bit further, depending on how you feel. You're going to roll the ball forwards, and as you go, you're going to drop your head, and then you're going to roll all the way back up again. So we want our spine to feel like we're going through that segmental control like we would do in a shoulder bridge, all the way down and out, and then all the way back up. I want you to feel like you're sitting up as high as you can on your sit bones. If you feel that your posture is quite slumped and that's really hard to do, then bring your legs closer together or even together. And like I said, you can roll the ball all the way down, all the way back up. Deep breath in, so feel your tummy. And breathe out and roll. All the way back up, deep breath in. And breathe out. And breathe in. And breathe out. Last one, breathing in. And breathing out. And rolling up. You can try it this time where you just hold on to your legs. And just drop your head and just try and stay there. So if you have been in my classes, we have been setting the challenge of to be able to touch our toes for 2019. So some of you are there, you've got your toes and your nose on your knees and your flexibility is wonderful. For others, you find that really, really hard. So we're just trying, after we've done the workout and our body is nice and warm, to just have a little practice each time. And trying, we don't want to bounce because we don't want to tear the muscles, we just want to really take our time. So you might find breathing, lifting up and over really helps, or you might find that you're just going to drop there and hold your head. And I promise you, if you practice and you're safe and there's no bouncing, that you aren't going to do yourself any damage. You find that you will be able to get a little bit more flexible each time. So that's something else you can practice. But always try and do it when you're warm and not when you haven't done any exercise. So let's just stretch our hip flexor. So if we're tucking our toes underneath, you're going to bring one leg forward. Now again here, we don't want to arch our back, so you're going to have put your hands down by your side and you're going to bring your weight nice and forward. And let it relax and go again. Give it a press, feeling that nice and stretch. And the leg that's behind in the hip flexor area, and swap legs. Keep the lower back pulled in, the lower back curved, sorry, pull the tummy in, and release it, and go again. Take that leg back. If you want to have one more shell stretch, you can. And let's come up to standing. So here, nice, soft spine, curve as you roll all the way back up, standing and growing nice and tall. So if you find the breathing linking to the exercises is really hard for you, this is a really good week to get some practice in and give it a try. If you have any questions or anything, you can always get in touch with any of us here at the studio and let us know. So hopefully I will see you all again next week, and I'm going to sign off now and finish. So thanks ever so much and have a good day. Take care.